right, here we go now. Welcome to UFC Quick Picks for UFC 241 in Anaheim, California. You guys know me. I am Joe Osborne. You know this guy, Iain MacMillan.
Hi.
Okay, let's get right down to business, and we'll start in the main event, which is a rematch for the heavyweight title between Daniel Cormier and Stipe Miocic. We have DC coming in at minus 140, Miocic coming back at plus 110, and I like the champ here. I like DC. I didn't like his opening number at minus 165, but I think minus 140 is much more fair. Listen, this guy, I think he's undersized for the division. He has the body of Reginald Val Johnson, but he is 15-0 as a heavyweight. He's only been beaten by one man, John Jones. Go back and watch the first fight between the two. I love DC's work in the clinch. His striking was fantastic. I just think he's the much more well-rounded fighter. He has the advantage in the grappling and probably in the striking too. So give me DC minus 140. What do you got?
Yeah, I agree with you. I'm taking DC as well. There was one point you made that I actually don't agree with, and that's that you said he's undersized at heavyweight. I actually think heavyweight's the perfect weight class for him. He's not as tall as these other heavyweight guys, but not having to cut weight actually adds to his power, and I think his power is actually underrated. Over his last three wins, two of those came from KO or TKO, and he has 10 KO wins in his career. Now, one thing I want to touch on as well is because this is a rematch, I actually have an article up at Odd Shark, check that out, of statistics in rematch fights, and in title fights specifically since 2012, the fighter who won the first fight has won the rematch. 17 out of 21 times is actually 17 out of 20 times before the Shevchenko-Karmouche rematch last weekend. But regardless, you got to bet on the guy who won the first fight, and at minus 140, I love that price, so give me DC.
Okay, nice plug there, Iain. Next up in the co-main event, we have a super sexy welterweight showdown between Anthony Showtime Pettis, and making his long-awaited return to the octagon is Nate Diaz. We have Pettis at minus 125, Diaz at minus 105. A lot of people I'm talking to are wondering, why isn't Pettis a biggest favorite or bigger favorite in this one? He looked pretty good in his welterweight debut, pulled off an upset victory over Stephen Wonderboy Thompson, of course. But listen, he's rotated wins and losses in 8 straight fights now. He's just 4-6 in his last 10 fights. I don't think the layoff will affect Nate very much at all, but I think this one is way too close to call. So the bet that I like most for this fight is for it to go to decision at minus 200. Diaz has only been finished once in his career in the UFC, and I don't think he has the power to finish Pettis. So decision minus 200. What do you have for this one?
I like that bet, especially because it's a 3-round fight. I mean, maybe 5 rounds, it wouldn't go there, but 3 rounds, I like it. Now, in that fight, I actually love Anthony Pettis. Now, on this show that we do and in Guys Bets, I've tossed around the terms underrated and overrated, but Nate Diaz is the most overrated fighter in the welterweight division, possibly in the UFC. He's overrated because of those McGregor fights. I mean, he won the first one. The second one was very close. I think he's overrated because of those fights. Now, it opened up as a pick'em, and it's moved to minus 140, and I think it's moving in the right direction, so jump on it as soon as possible. The blueprint to how to beat one of the Diaz brothers is out. You got to attack the leg, and you got to stay in kicking range, and that's exactly what Anthony Pettis' skill set is geared towards doing. If he can just attack Nate Diaz's front leg because Diaz put so much weight on it, it's gonna be a long night for Nathan. So I am gonna take Anthony Pettis at minus 140. I just think if he sticks to an intelligent game plan, I don't see how he's gonna lose this fight. Unless he gets into a boxing brawl, then that's where it's gonna be questionable. But I like Pettis at minus 140.
Very nice. Okay, maybe my favorite fight on this card. This is a mega middleweight showdown between Paulo Costa and Yoel Romero. We have Costa coming in at plus 130. Romero coming back minus 160, over a year layoff for each fighter. I think this fight is much closer to a coin flip, so in situations like this, I'm always going to go with the underdog. Costa, 12-0 in his career, 4-0 in the UFC, 4 TKO victories. We have Romero, 42 years old. You know, father time catches up to every athlete. I think it's going to catch up to Romero in this one, going against Costa, who I think has all the skills to be one of the best pound-for-pound fighters in the sport. So give me the underdog. What do you think?
I don't necessarily hate that pick. Now, like you said at the start, that's completely a toss-up for me. So that fight's actually a stay away for me. I'm not going to bet either way on it. But there's another fight on the main card. It's the opening fight on the main card that I absolutely love. I'm going to take Iain Heinisch at minus 155 over Derek Brunson. So I've been high on Iain Heinisch ever since he made his UFC debut, and it's not just because we share the same name.
Couple of Iains.
Yeah. He doesn't have the second I in his name, so he's not quite the same. But he has very few holes in his game. He's quick. He's powerful. He has great cardio, and he has vicious ground and pound. If he did have one weakness, I would say it'd be his submission defense, but Derek Brunson's not exactly a jiu-jitsu phenom.
I'd say his one weakness is that his name is also Iain.
That's a strength. But speaking of Brunson, I think he's actually at the tail end of his career. He's looked slow in his last few fights. I think he's lost a step. Now, I still think he obviously has power. The power is always the last thing to go. But I think for Brunson to win this fight, he's just going to have to catch Heinisch. He has a puncher's chance, so that's why I like Heinisch at minus 155.
Hey, I like that pick, Iain. So that is it for UFC Quick Picks, but we have a ton of coverage on this event on the website right now from our guy Scotty Hastings, who isn't with us right now. He breaks down all the big fights, and of course, we have live odds for all the fights right up until Saturday night. Find that right now over at oddshark.com, the pound-for-pound king of sports. Betting news!